Welcome, friends! Today we're gonna talk about a character creation in MechaJammer. We all know how important character creation is, cause all journey will depend on what type of character will you create. So leave a like, subscribe to my channel, cause I plan to do a lot of more videos about MechaJammer, and let's start! Every situation in MechaJammer can be solved by three different approaches, ways. You can fight your way through, you can use a stealth and sneak in, and you just can talk your way through any situation. So, we will discuss a fighter, a thief, and a diplomat. And of course, I will show you a type of character I personally choose to play this game. And I love to play scientist, so it will be a scientist type of character. Okay, let's start with the fighter. Fighter will be divided into the melee fighter and ranged weapons fighter. And one more thing, as you get older, your muscles become weaker but mind becomes stronger, so the game says. So if you choose to be a melee fighter, don't go too deep, be younger when you create your character. Let's start with abilities. So, Pain Threshold is very important skill, really important for any character. It will increase your life points and make regeneration faster, so let's put point in these stats. Then we have a Muscular Mass, and if you choose a melee fighter, put 2 points into this field, cause it's really very important for melee fighters. And of course, Grace. Grace is also very important statistic for melee fighters. And where to put the last skill is completely up to you. You can put it here and make a true brutal melee warrior. Or you can add something else to your character like quietness or learning. Learning is very important because it will give you a repair chemistry and you will be able to hack and even speak languages. But maybe a warrior don't need it, so let's put it this way. And now it's a good time to choose what type of weapon do you like most. Maybe one-handed like knives, two-handed like swords, or impact, polish, throwing, chain. And we also will need blocking, or maybe just unarmed. It's also a very good choice for melee fighter. It doesn't really matter what kind of weapon you choose, just choose what you like, what you prefer better. For example, knives, you will need a knives. And chained, always want to play with chained weapons, so I will put 2 points in this. And of course, blocking, melee fighter will need blocking a lot. And you have 2 more cube studies to spread. One will go to throwing, cause you will throw in knives and other stuff, it's important for melee type of fighter. And the last cube you can spend on any of these skills, depending on what do you like. For example, if you want to unlock locked doors, put it here. Or maybe you want to be a little bit of doctor kind of character, then put it right here. Or a hacking, it's completely up to you. And when you will choose a job which matches with the weapon you choose. So, I love chained weapons, and I will be looter, no, dog worker. Perfect, 2 impact and 2 chained. So, I will choose a dog worker. Now it's time to choose our weakness, a bad side. And if you're playing a true melee fighter, of course, choose a head injury, because it will give you -3 to your social success role. But we don't want to talk to people, we want to hit them hard. So let's choose it. And that's it. A melee fighter must be young. Now, let's talk about a range fighter. And I know many people say range weapon is bad in this game. It's not bad, it's just a little bit weird. But the whole game is weird, so it's okay. Really, I don't find any problems with ranged weapons, so I decide to include it in my character creation. For ranged weapon, what do we need most is perception. It's really, really very important, cause it increases aiming and increase successful rolls for all range type of guns. And we also will need a grace, cause it reduces reload turns, and it also will be very important. So I will do something like this. For pure fighter, of course, you can be a ranged scientist or thief or something like that. But if you want to be a pure ranged fighter, you should choose something resembling this. Now let's move on to studies. And what do we have here? We have slug guns, laser guns, plasma guns. And actually you can choose all of them or choose your best weapon. I will do it like this. And you will have a true skills, free skills. You can put one in nice, for example, or completely use it in this scientist field of character. Now let's choose a profession. He also will be young because he is a fighter and he need to be young. And both of those first options have very good profession. And this profession is trooper. Yes, it gives you slightly increase in all of ranged weapons. So we will choose it. But my friends, PSD, nerves damage. All of them are completely terrible. So just read description and choose which one is better for you. I will choose a nerve damage, but I'm not sure it's a very good choice. Really, all of them are bad. Maybe even the first one is better. But you will decide it by yourself. It's a role-playing game. And that's it. He also will be young. The next character we will create will be a thief, a master of stealth and sneaking. And most important attributes will be quietness, very important, and of course grace. But maybe even do something like this, cause it's really very important. And pay attention to learning, cause it will give a chemistry and hacking, and good thief must be good at hacking. So let's choose this one also. What about studies? I strongly advise you to put one into knife and two simple guns. You will really need it, and what's most important for thief. Yes, you already guess it will be this skill, cause it represents everything a good thief just must have. Unlocking the doors, doing sleeping attacks, everything. So we will put 3 points into this skill, and of course, good old hacking. And by the way, you can take one skill and put it into chemistry if you want to create grenades, oil, and all that stuff. Now it's time to choose a profession. We will choose a natural birth, cause it's best way for thieves. Cause we will have a pickpocket and looter. Both of these skills are very good, really. It will increase your bulgari and pickpoint will increase a lot of stuff. Oh, it's barely see, but chains, slug weapons, and also a true plus bulgari. So you can choose one and then age a little bit to 30 and choose a pickpocket. It's all good choices, looter or pickpoint. Well, we got a good thief. He's quiet enough, he have a grace, a little bit of learning and hacking, and good at bulgari. So you will move into the shadows, you will hack computers and do your stealth sneak attacks. I think it will be a good choice for thief. It's time to create a diplomat kind of character. And what's most important for diplomat? Of course, a social skill, because you will be able to talk to gang members and recruit a lot of troopers, soldiers, and they will fight for you, and you will stay and just watch and give them commands. You guys go here and you go there. For this, we will create, of course, choose a pantry hold, because it very useful for everyone, but main point will be occult, cause it increase your organics and social. Learning also will be very good, cause it will give you knowledge about languages. Okay, so we focus on those two skills, abilities. And now, how do we distribute our studies? Every diplomat must have a knife or a gun behind his fancy jacket, or any case, so choose one of these skills. And of course, a lot of social. I will put 3 on social, we will have 2 left, and you can use it any way you like. Maybe you will be good at knives, and maybe you will be good at organics. You will be able to heal people. Which professions to choose for diplomats? There are no certain good profession for diplomats, but there are few that's pretty good, like gig worker, because it gives you a lot of different stuff, and one to social, or data entry, also very good profession. And do not choose anything that will decrease your social skill. I'll be a coward. Oh, bad aim? Okay, I will survive it. Okay, let's be a coward. And this time we will choose yes, cause diplomats, you see? Now we can have 2 of them. Is really don't suffer from his age. This time we will have a few interesting choices. I will choose a vendor. I just like it and it gives me additional social. You see, now the bonus is 2. Oh, I will be hungry. Good diplomat is always a hungry diplomat. And yes, again. And now we can have all these skills. And right here you can choose something like data entry, because it will give you hacking and social again. It's always a good choice. And from the bad sides, I will choose 2 left feet, because why not, friends? Why not? It sounds good, it must be a good to have 2 left feet. I don't know, but maybe it's a very good idea. Okay, and it's time to stop. No, this way no. Of course, you can go further, but it's enough bad feet for me. I already have 2 left feet. It's time to stop. So, now we have a very well done diplomat that will help you to solve every situation in your favor and control a lot of soldiers who will fight for you. And it's time to show you a character which I choose for myself. I always love to play as a wizard, but there are no wizards in this game, so I will be a scientist. Scientist is always a good choice. I will put all points in learning and occult. And of course, a little bit here, but mostly learning. And I will use a laser gun. Yes, a laser gun, because a good scientist must have a laser gun or a plasma gun, but somehow I like laser guns better. And I be a little good at everything, at hacking, repairing, of course social, because I will need to talk my way through, and at chemistry. Yes, this is my personal choice. It's not a perfect, but I don't like to play perfect characters. I like to play characters I want to play. Okay, I will choose a natural boss. Let's go. And right here I will choose a gig worker, because it gives everything a good scientist must have. Very well choice. Okay. Bad back. Recovery, more recovery. Okay, I will have a bad back. Because I really don't have such a great back in my real life. Oh, I'm older. And what was I doing this time? It's a good choice for a doctor, but not for me. Vendor. Not security. No security. Again, dog worker. I will choose a looter, cause I don't have points in this skill and I need to unlock doors somehow. So, looter will be a good choice. Yes, let's go. Yes, of course. Let's move on. I will never stop here. And I need all these skills to be active, so I have to choose higher age. And this time I will choose a vendor. Yes. Cause it give me +1 to social, and it's good to have a talking skill like that. Of course, hungry, I'm always hungry, and it's time to stop. No, I don't want to be very weak in this game. I'm a scientist, they must be weak, but okay, that will be enough. So friends, now you know all type of characters and my opinion about them, and even the character I choose for myself. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel, cause I plan to make a lot of guides about this game, cause I really like it. So I will meet you there. Till the next video, friends. See you!